Good evening, viewers. Welcome to People and Stories. I'm your host, Jackie Nalubama. Tonight, we have someone very interesting. He is living a very interesting life at such a young age. I hope he inspires you as much as he will inspire me. Hello, welcome to the show.
I appreciate it. My name is Darren Harry Bainey. I am 21 years old, currently studying in Canada at the University of Waterloo, doing a degree in biology, bioinformatics. Happy to be here, happy to share a bit of my story and hopefully, like you said, inspire the people watching, inspire you, and see what my journey can help inform the people watching.
So what is life like in Canada?
It's interesting. It's different, first of all, culturally, but also different in the way you express yourself in terms of what you're given the opportunity to do. I remember my first time in Canada was in 2022, January. You can imagine I went at winter after COVID because I started my degree in 2020. But the first time I actually went to Canada was 2021 in January. I'll never forget the first thing that hit me when I walked out of the airport was the fact that it was negative 15 okay. degrees. So I was coming from Uganda's tropical climate, going into Canada, and that was the first shock. But getting used to the system, I remember I worked two jobs last year. I started off working at Waterloo International. That's a subsidiary under the University of Waterloo. I was an international relations analyst helping the university form partnerships with other institutions globally. And it was a very wonderful experience because I learned a lot about how partnerships are built from an international level. And then my second job, which for me I think has been the best so far, okay. was when I worked at Canada's Children's Hospital Foundation. Basically what it is the mother of all the individual hospital foundations, all non-profit across Canada, really helping children that have either born with disabilities or parents and families that cannot afford to take care of their children. That's essentially what that organization does, and it was a wonderful experience because it aligned with where my journey sort of seems to be going, which is the non-profit aspect, but also working with children, understanding how that works. And
so what were you doing exactly?
I was a corporate partnerships and ESG intern, so that's environmental, social and governance intern. And my role was basically helping the directors plan projects of where they would get finances from these big corporates like Walmart to then support the surgeries of these young children. So, because yes, it's a non-profit, so they require support from these for-profit organizations like the Walmarts, the Dairy Queens. And the biggest project that I actually did was I managed the Spark a Miracle campaign, which is basically where Walmart Canada designs plushies that are basically toys that they sell. And the money that they generate from that revenue goes to the foundation. And I remember we generated $4.5 million.
Oh, wow.
And it was just interesting to see how a company like that is able to generate revenue solely for the purpose of helping people, and it really inspired me to.
Sorry, we jumped into Canada, but I would like to know, who's Darren?
What I always say is that Darren is first and foremost a son to two incredibly inspirational people as well, Pearl and Christian Bainey, and firstborn to three other siblings that I have. But also he's an inspired work in progress. And that's something that I learned in 2021. And essentially what it means and how it aligns with what I'm doing is that on this journey that I'm on in wanting to learn and wanting to develop myself, there's still a lot of work. And because of that, I'm a work in progress. But because I learn from different facets and different areas of life, there's a lot of inspiration that I draw from that. And it's what I think terms me as an inspired work in progress. So.
But let's go back a bit. Before you went to Canada, what influenced your decision to go to Canada? Did you look around and think to yourself, my care, no, UCU, no, Nkozi University, no?
No, first of all, those are really great universities. Yeah. It's just that, I had done the International Baccalaureate Diploma Program. And it was a very rigorous program. And
from
it's
high
Aga Khan High School here in Uganda, Kampala. And essentially what that diploma program did is it opened me into an international perspective in how I view the world. But to answer the question directly, Canada, because of the opportunities that it gives, the university that I'm with, the University of Waterloo, is really focused on creating citizens that have an impact in society. So they have a core program that they run. So as you study, you work. And I think that experience that Canada has given me in terms of allowing me to work is what was one of the main reasons I chose to go to Canada. On top of having family there, but...
Perhaps I wasn't clear. Your decision, how did you arrive at that decision? Because the world is big. It could have been America, could have been the UK, could have been Germany. Why Canada?
Why Canada? I just think because, one, how open and free it is as a nation. One, to allowing people from different parts of the world to come. Mm-hmm. It's not a very racist country. It is liberal in that sense. They, like I said previously, the work experience that you get is really something that I think is valuable, mm-hmm. because it was aligning with what characteristics and traits I needed to get. Mm-hmm. I remember I did look at the UK. I applied to the UK, but mm-hmm. I remember at the time my parents were saying that there needs to be a path after you graduate. And obviously with Canada, there seems to be a path in terms of when you do graduate, getting permanent residence and becoming a citizen. But that's not the goal or the entire reason as to why I'm there. It's just an additive to one of the perks of being in Canada.
Oh, okay. So you say you have this foundation. Tell us about your foundation.
Yes, so the Young Guy Foundation. Started off as a school project in 2019.
At
A-level, going back to the IBDP program, mm-hmm. they required that you do a project that is a self-initiated project that helps communities and helps, you know, just better the society that you're in. Okay. So I remember at that time I said, you know, why don't I try going to
social
a school?
Entrepreneurship.
Social entrepreneurship, exactly. Mm-hmm. So I remember I went to Bombo, Luwero. I did a situational analysis of a school in Bombo, just understanding what they would need, interacting with the children, the teachers, the administration. That was in August of 2019. And I realized that this is actually something that I think will have considerate impact in what it is I'm trying to do. But mind you, at the time, it was 2019, I was just looking at doing the project.
getting the marks.
And so, yeah. You know, I finished what I needed to do. But I remember in November, when we now actually implemented the project, the level of impact that we saw and how it really helped change the lives of the people we're working with.
When you say implemented the project, what exactly did you do?
What we did is we donated scholastic materials from books, pens, learning charts, chalk, chairs, to help the school run for a period of at least a year. And I remember actually New Vision came and they wrote an interesting article. They said, teenager adopts school. Although that wasn't the... So that's exactly how it started. And then with time, I saw that this is actually something that I could actually continue. Simply because of the level of impact that that we saw at that specific event. But then 2020 came, COVID happened, and we really couldn't do what we needed to do. So we went back to the drawing board, started to reevaluate what exactly we were trying to do. And that's when I reached out to different friends, Rachel, my friends Ashley, Achol, my brothers, my parents, and I said, let's see how we can create a foundation that has a proper structure. That's when I went back, I sat down, and I said, what are two focus areas that Uganda is looking at, and the international market as well, because I wasn't just looking at the work I'm doing, from just a local perspective, but viewing it long term on an international level. And then I saw early childhood care and education as one of the arms we could focus on, that primarily being how can we support schools from the work that we had already done, donation of resources, and then infrastructure development of the school. But then the flip side, we were looking at how can we work with marginalized youth. So we went to the Nagur Remand Home. We did a donation to the home that lasted of food resources. We gave them sugar, plates, cups, flour for a year period. But then I remember when we did that donation, the matron, Maria, at the time said, you know, in as much as you're giving us these things, we need to create youth that are going to have an impact when they leave the remand home. So it's not that there needs to be a value added.
True.
So we said, okay, why don't we,
not just supplies,
yeah? Exactly. So we said, why don't we, on top of what we're giving, let's see if we can skill them. So we spoke to her, and then we started our hair braiding and nail dressing skill building program that ran for 3 months last year. And now, those are the two areas we focus on: marginalized youth, early childhood care and development. But that started as just a simple project in 2019 and see
just to get the grade.
But seeing the love of impact, seeing the journey that it has had since then, lots of learning points, it's been difficult, but we are.
Have you been back to Bombo since?
Yes, I have. I went back in 2021, right before I left to go to Canada. And the people were very happy to see we brought in more resources. Obviously, they had cut down a little bit on the operations because schools at that time were really struggling. So the administration said that they had cut down a little bit on the resources, on the teaching. And so it was a bit difficult to see that they were changing the direction in which they were trying to go to.
We're going for a short break, but we shall return with Darren. Keep watching.